In this video, I want to teach you how to think like an automation architect. Because I see so many people asking me, how do I build this bot, Brad? And they don't actually have a clue. It's like, I mean, and I get it, because we all begin somewhere, right? But they don't quite understand what it is they're actually trying to accomplish. And so when I ask them, okay, well, what outputs do you want? They look at me like I'm crazy. Like, well, I want it to do this. Okay, well, how do you want it to do that? I don't know. Okay, well, what inputs are you going to have? I mean, I'm just going to get some information. Like, so I wanted to make this video to kind of do a quick breakdown to help you think like someone who actually builds automations, because it's actually really, really simple. There's only three things you need for every system. Every system only needs three things. You need inputs, you need to process those inputs somehow, and then you need to output that data somehow. All right, if you don't have those three things, you don't have a system. So as you're going in and you're beginning to build your bots, you need to think in terms of the beginning, what happens, and the end. All right, and I think it was the seven laws of highly effective people, whatever it was called, right? Where I think his first rule was begin with the end in mind. What is the goal? What are you trying to accomplish? And if you don't know that, it makes it really hard in order to build your bot. So we're starting on number three, right? We're gonna kind of go in reverse order here. How do you get the information out in the way that you want it? Do you want the information in a spreadsheet? Like, are you just processing data? So maybe it's customer data comes in, it comes out as, you know, part of your CRM. Is that it? Is that all you're trying to do? Okay, well then I can figure out how to kind of backtrack the data in order to get it there. But if you don't have a clue, if you're just like, well, I just want to make a bot that, you know, is able to post on social media. Okay, well, how do you want it to post? What kind of options do you want? Do you want just text post? Do you want image post? Do you want video post? Do you want, which platform do you want it on? And you don't know, it makes it really hard to help you. Okay, so think, what exactly does this bot need to be able to do for you? Write it out, okay? Because then you can step it back. Okay, well, in order to be able to write it out, you need different kinds of tools in order to make that happen. So here I have a super simple bot. All right, super, super simple. All it does is I'm gonna click this button down here, click trigger. I have an AI agent that is literally just gonna say hello to you too. All right, I don't even need the AI agent technically. I can come in here to Slack and write in hello to you too, okay? Either way, I have all three elements here. I have an input, I have processing and an output. My input to my AI agent is the word hello and its system prompt, okay? The system prompt is also an input. It's what information that this AI agent is getting. This is the instruction it's supposed to follow. Here is just me saying something to it, all right? When I click the button, the AI agent is going to get that input. The information is going to be sent to OpenAI because I'm using a ChatGPT trigger, an OpenAI trigger, or an LLM here, right? That's the model I'm using. It's being sent to OpenAI. It's going to process that information and return literally what I told it to say, which is hello to you too, and it's going to output hello to you too. It's then going to send it, this is the output part, to me via Slack. It's going to send the message. So again, this also has input, right? It's getting the input from the AI agent. It's the process it's gonna do is sending, and the output is, I'm gonna see it here in Slack in just a second. So let's go ahead and, oh, where did we go? What happened? This one. All right, let's go ahead and just test execute workflow, and boom, completed. I check, boom, hello to you too. My bot sent me my message. That's the output. The output is a Slack message. All right, the output is not just this AI agent. This is part of the process. All of the information coming in and coming out are inputs, processes, and outputs. Every single node has an input, a process, and an output. This node has an input. It's getting the message from the AI agent. The process is it's sending the message. The output is the result here on Slack. But there's also the larger input, process, and output. The agent itself needs to be able to get the information in, process it somehow, and then output it somewhere. All right, so this is how you can think like an automation architect. It's thinking in terms of these three items: inputs, processes, and outputs. If you cannot figure out each of those three things, you don't have an automation. All right. You're just kind of building. All right. And I think that's really all there is to it. It's not much more complicated. Like I said, this isn't a particularly complex subject. It can become complex when you're building because you might have more than one input, right? You might have inputs coming in from chat messages, from spreadsheets, from your vector store memory. You might have like complex memory systems that are giving an input memory. You have all kinds of stuff. And I have other videos on this. Like I'll try to remember to put a video on agent memory in the link description below that talks about the different kinds of inputs that your AI agent might have. But all of that information is just information. It just sits there. It's not doing anything. It's just the data that came in. You need to process it somehow, whether that's writing something or transforming the data or, you know, looping through it and doing different kinds of things to it or generating outlines and whatever the process is, you have to figure out what are those steps. And that's why I have so many different types of workflows in my free school community that you all have access to absolutely for free. Links in the description below if you want to go get it. All right. All of them. I got tons of them that have all kinds of different processes that you can use. And you don't have to use them just in that one bot. You can take them and put them in other bots and hook them up and rearrange them in all kinds of different ways. Either way, the different processes are just kind of the middle part. And then you got the output, the part that actually people care about, the result. I mean, no one's building automations just because they like building automations. I mean, I'm sure there are. But those of us who are business people who actually care about the result, we're doing and using these things to get something out of it. So if you don't know what that is, if you're not working toward that output, then you're just wasting your time. So that's what I want to share with you all today. If you found this video helpful, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, like and share the video. It really does help get this information out there to those who need it. And again, if you want all those workflows I mentioned, if you want additional tutorials, links in the description below to go to my free school community. Everything's absolutely free. I give it all away. I don't charge for any of it. As always, I'm Bradford Carlton. Let's automate your success together.